So let's start, everybody.
Recording in progress.
Good morning, everybody. All of you.
Morning, sir.
Good morning. Let's start, everybody. We're in the chapter.
Fifth chapter.
Income from house property, right, all of you? Are you high, na?
Yes, sir.
See, now there is no lag at all.
Sir, HDR
sir, yeah, setting a problem in classroom. Ka. There is some, I don't know what is the issue. I think it is internet only. Anyways,
internet is
for sure. There is no lag at all na, here.
No, sir. Pura clear.
Dekh rahe, sir. Focus sir. Kya bolne ka
chamak rahe ho, sir.
Dekho na, yaar, wo kitna kala karta mere ko. Bichara. Anyways. Let's start, everybody. We are in which chapter? Income from house property. Okay, everybody. And we did which concept yesterday? Very important concept we did yesterday. Very important concept, bachcho. Which one? 24B.
Pre-construction.
Pre-construction period or pre-possession period. Interest, okay?
Interest
on borrowed capital. So, the deduction you'll get for repayment of principal or repayment of interest? Only for?
Repayment of interest.
Only for repayment of interest. And like yesterday I explained to you, that without house property, the income of, I mean, this chapter is not at all, you can say, relevant if the house property is not yet ready. You know? So, till the time period the house property gets ready, that is the construction period or, you know, whatever the compliance period for you might have started paying, repaying the loan, but you have not yet got the possession of the property. That period is called as pre-construction or pre-possession period. But still you are paying interest and property is not yet ready. So your chapter is not yet ready. Okay, chapter means what? Income from house property is not ready. So you cannot use it, but you're paying interest. So I told you yesterday in the last lecture that even that interest you will be allowed to get deduction, but only when the property is ready. Yes or no, all of you? Clear till you? So from which year? Very important, now please pay attention. From which year you will start getting deduction of that interest paid in under construction period or during construction period? From which year, everybody? The year in which? Are you there now, all of you? The year in which construction is?
Completed.
The year in which construction is completed. Can I say irrespective of the date of completion?
Yes.
Understood or no, everybody? Irrespective of the date of construction. It can be 1st April now, 21 or 31st March, 22. All right, Leo. Within that period, any day, the construction is completed, for that PY, you can start claiming from that PY, pre-construction period and as well as current year period. Okay, so we had solved a question on that also. Okay, let's go ahead now. Very important, the calculation of pre-construction period interest. It starts from?
From the date of loan disbursement.
From the date of disbursement of loan. All of you agree?
Yes.
And ends on before, that is earlier of?
Preceding 31st March
or
the repayment of the loan.
Entire repayment of the loan. Yes or no, all of you? Yes. Pakka. So guys, you have to keep those provisions in mind. Hai na? If you don't know the provisions, then we cannot solve the question, any question. Chik hai? All of you okay, Dalio?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go ahead. Okay. So date of complete repayment of loan or 31st March, whichever is earlier, at that period your time period will get over of that pre-construction period, of the pre-construction period. And now for the entire pre-construction period, whatever interest you calculate, will that entire amount you will get in the year of completion immediately?
No.
Entire amount will you get, bachcho? No, you will get only now. It will be spread over a period of?
5 years.
Five years.
The first year from which you will start getting that 1/5 is which year? Guru.
Sir.
Tell me the answer. The year from which you start getting that 1/5 benefit is which year?
Sir, jisme complete hota hai uske agle.
Uske agle saal.
Agle,
sir. From the year itself.
ये तो तू इधर आ जा वरना मैं उधर आता हूँ, है ना. वन फिफ्थ ऑफ सच प्री कंस्ट्रक्शन पीरियड शैल बी अलाउड फॉर 5 years बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम द ईयर इन विच कंस्ट्रक्शन इज कंप्लीटेड. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड और नो एवरीबॉडी?
यस सर.
ओ मेरे भाई, लेट अस से कंस्ट्रक्शन कंप्लीशन डेट इज, पे अटेंशन. आदित्य ओके, रितिका
यस सर.
कंस्ट्रक्शन कंप्लीशन डेट इज लेट अस से 1st December 2021. ओके सी गुरु, फॉर द प्री कंस्ट्रक्शन पीरियड यू विल बी चेकिंग 31st March प्रीसीडिंग दिस डेट. तो व्हाट इज व्हाट डेट देन? 31st March प्रीसीडिंग 1st December इज व्हाट? 31st March 2021. That is just one of the dates which you will check for what? Completion of or where the pre-question period gets over. Okay? For calculation purpose. Actual construction got completed when? On 1st December 21. Correct or wrong? So, whatever pre-question period you have calculated till here, that interest, you will start getting now 1/5 of that from the year in which construction is completed. That is what? PY? 21-22 onwards. Understood or no?
Yes.
Okay. Sameer, Aditya, Ritika, Latik, Vedika,
yes, Rishti,
Pushkar.
Yes, sir.
Or jiska naam miss kar diya.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. Can I go ahead? Now understand, I'm going to do some little other basic things now. Theek hai? Pakka? Now check. Types of house property. Again, a very important concept. Types of house property. Clear all of you? Self-occupied, let out, and deemed to be let out. Okay? Self-occupied, let out, and deemed to be let out. First of all, this entire head of income is for which type of OCC bachcho? Who is owner of the property or not? Tell me. This chapter
owner.
Applicable for the owner of the house property. Yes or no? So our assessee is the landlord or tenant? Landlord.
Landlord.
When I say landlord means owner, okay? Property owner. Okay? So this property owner, this asset is there, no? House property asset is there. This property owner may utilize that property. Check in how many ways? I'm not talking about purpose means residential purpose or commercial purpose now. The property may be self-occupied. Self-occupied means what? He has a property and he himself is occupying it. Understood or no?
Yes.
What did I say? There is an owner, there is a property. Now this is deemed. This is now the basic of this chapter, correct? Now the owner may be utilizing the property for himself. Understood or no? Pakka? Let us say you yourself have a property. You own it and you are occupying it. Clear till here, everybody? Use common sense and tell me, will you get rent income from there?
No, sir.
Obviously not. Are you getting bachcho any rent income? Tell me. No, no, because you are occupying that property. So you will be asking, sir, then why are we discussing it? First, let us understand, no? What all types of property are there? So we are giving your types of house property. Hey, kini bachcho? All of you okay till here?
Yes, sir.
So use common sense. If it is self-occupied, then what? We are not getting rent income. That's why the law says simply GAV is nil of a self-occupied property. Gross annual value is what, bachcho? Nil. GAV you have seen, no? FR or SR, MV or FR subject to SR?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here the law says, the Income Tax Act says, if the property is what, bachcho? SOP. SOP is what? Self-occupied property. GAV is nil. Now try to understand the sequence. If GAV is nil, municipal taxes will be what, bachcho? Whatever it is, the figure is there. NAV will not be negative, okay? Let me say, okay? So they are saying GAV is nil and NAV is also nil. NAV will not be negative. Clear till here? Try to understand here. 24A will be positive, negative or zero?
Zero.
Municipal taxes also bachcho nil, huh? So GAV nil, municipal taxes are not allowed, forget it. NAV is nil. Okay, NAV is nil, then 24A, standard deduction.
Nil.
Zero. Only what remains? 24B. Interest on borrowed capital. Are you understanding here, everybody? Again, I'll repeat. Check. Types of property. Check. If the house property is used for self-residential purposes by the assessee, then it is treated as what, bachcho? Self-occupied property. So simple wordings, no? In that case, GAV and NAV will be nil because, pay attention, municipal taxes paid by the owner during the previous year will not be allowed as deduction. Here they are not taxing your GAV, so they are also not allowing what, bachcho? Municipal taxes. Understood or no, everybody? Pakka? All of you?
Yes, sir.
GAV is nil. Municipal taxes, then they are not allowing. Therefore, NAV is nil. 24A will be by default nil. What remains? Interest will be deductible. Interest will be deductible. Understood or no, all of you? So come back in our format again. Just check. Don't write down anything. Just check. In case of self-occupied property, bachcho. GAV how much? Nil. Hai na? Municipal taxes allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Therefore, as it is, NAV will be nil. If NAV is nil, standard deduction will be nil. But what are they telling you? Interest on borrowed capital is allowed. That is allowed. So if you pay interest on borrowed capital for a self-occupied property, use common sense, it will result in income or loss. Tell me, it will result in income from house property or loss from house property, bachcho?
Loss.
All others are sleeping. Vedika, Shushti, Ritik. Ritika.
No, sir. Loss.
Loss, understood or no?
Yes, understood.
If this is, bachcho, let us say for example, 100 rupees. I'm just giving example, 100. Paid. Interest on borrowed capital. So what is the entire total calculation here? 100 negative. When I say negative, obviously that will be what, bachcho, in that case? Loss. Hai na? Loss from house property. Clear till here? All of you okay or not till here?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt as such, ask me. No problem.
Sir, because there is nothing to deduct, so there is only loss. Only interest is there, so loss.
Ha, but yeah, if interest is accruing for the year, matlab that assumption will be there. Only if there is a loan on the property, no? How will we take randomly anything, okay? So, if imagine you have a house property, okay? Every Indian person, every person, especially typical people, they have their own dream. They want their own house property, okay? So, entire life savings, they invest in this house property. They take 20, 30 years ka loan and they pay almost 70-80% of their income in EMI, okay? Okay, tell you. Why? Because they don't want to stay anywhere on rent. They want their own property. Okay, Dilya, are you understanding the example? This is, I think, what, 99% people, those have taken home loan, this is their case. That they have taken home loan for their own occupation. Occupation means using the property for self-residence. Clear, Dilya?
Hai na? Yes, sir.
So, they are using it for themselves. They want a nameplate on that property, our property. They don't want to pay rent anywhere else. So, they are occupying themselves. GAV nil. Municipal tax is not allowed. NAV nil. So NAV nil, so standard deduction will not be there. But these people have taken a loan. Big loan. Or they are repaying the loan. Loan they are repaying na. So interest on borrowed capital will be allowed as deduction. So that will result in what? Negative income, or you can say loss. But yes, however, let us say if the loan is completely repaid or loan was never taken, then again, if there is no loan on the property and you are occupying for yourself, then again, interest on borrowed capital will be nothing over there, practically speaking. Okay? But legally speaking, it is allowed or not allowed? That is the question. Allowed, everybody, tell me.
Yes, sir.
All of you understood or no? Guru, samjha?
Okay.
Okay, let's go ahead, everybody.
Yes, sir.
Vedika, any doubt ask? Huh? Vedika,
yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir?
Bolo.
So municipal taxes तो अपन मतलब municipality के services लेते इसलिए देते हैं ना तो income रहे या नहीं रहे पर अपनों को तो देना पड़ेगा ना अपन खुद भी रह रहे तो
हाँ तो that's what I'm saying there are two different things your actual expenditures and expenditure allowed for income tax purpose are different things Now, honestly speaking, now understand. Again, I'll repeat the example. Don't worry. Imagine you have taken a property, you know, for self-residence. You are staying in a society, and society charges rupees 1,000 per month as this. What do you
maintenance.
Say? Maintenance. Correct. Now check GAV nil, municipal taxes. Leave it aside right now. Not allowed. NAV nil, and even that 30% is also not allowed. Okay. So expenditures are not allowed as such. Now pay attention, because again the income is not taxed. Which income is not taxed? GAV. They are taking it as here as what? Nil. So your actual expenditure of municipal taxes may be there, but it is not allowed. Your society maintenance expenses or other expenses may be there, but even that is not being covered in the standard deduction. Clear? Understood or no? Small things here and there will not, that is not allowed in then SOP. Hello. Aditya, I think online. Okay, all of you. Samjha ki nahi?
Yes, sir.
So only one expenditure which is actually happening is allowed is which one? Tell me. Interest accrued. And I mean, when I say interest, I hope you notice on accrual basis only, na? That basic, don't forget. Basics, don't forget. Okay, all of you. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Pakka na, everybody. So expenditure is there. Municipal taxes or your society maintenance or other thing also, but that is for income tax purpose for section this this chapter, it is not allowed. They are not allowing it because income itself is not getting taxed. Clear? So all the examples we did till now, that's why they were purposely, they have given in that question. It was let out. Hey, Kini? Clear? Understood? I'll go ahead.
Yes, sir.
So keep one thing in mind now. Is there cash flow in SOP property? Cash flow, when I say cash flow, means cash inflow.
No, sir.
There is no cash inflow. Okay, everybody? Are you high? You are not getting any cash or income by when the property is as used as SOP, self-occupied property. Okay? Chalega? Exactly opposite of that, any property owned by an assessee is let out. Let out means what? Not get out. Let out means what, bachcho? Actually given
on rent.
On rent, okay. I'll just write down a word over here. Actually given on rent. So here you tell me now, is there cash inflow?
Yes.
So in SOP, there is no cash inflow. Okay. You have to also understand, legally also we have to understand, practically also we have to understand. Okay. So in let out, bachcho, there is actually cash inflow. And now cash inflow, these things we have done. Calculation of GAV, etc. we have done. The valuation may be 20,000 rupees per month. But you may be getting 15,000 rupees per month. Or you may be getting 25,000 rupees per month. Depending on the calculation, we have seen that, no? In GAV. Higher of MV or FR subject to SR. Yes or no, everybody tell me. Understood? But let out is what bachcho actually given on rent, so that there is a actually cash income to the assessee. So the house property is given on rent, then the income shall be computed as per the format already discussed, which you have seen. Do you remember? If it is given on rent but the tenant doesn't pay the rent, what happens? If the tenant doesn't pay the rent,
less
kar to
unrealized rent.
Unrealized rent, bachcho. Rule 4, if you remember. Hai na? All of you? Fine, Delio?
Yes, sir.
It is done. And now we come to a very interesting, different concept. Okay? At times difficult to digest. Is deemed to be let out. First of all, deemed means what? This we have done in law also. Deemed means?
Assumed.
Very good. Voice and audio, video, everything is okay, na, everybody? Vedika Srishti, especially you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, jhakas. Assumed. Ready, everybody? So, assumed to be let out. Is it actually let out? So, this is bachcho actually let out, the second column. Okay, everybody? I have written that already. But here we are assuming to be let out. Assuming to be let out. Clear, dear? if you remember the basic discussion of house property, what I had told you, what is actually taxed in house property, bachcho? Rent income. Let me use the word actual. Or what was some other word I had used, if you remember?
Accrued. Deemed to be accrued.
Deemed to be accrued, what else?
Deemed to be received.
What do we tax in a house property? Actual rent or rents?
Annual value. Revenue income.
Income generating capacity. It is an asset, bachcho. House property is an asset. Clear, Delia? Capital asset, yes or no? But that asset can earn some income or not, that we are checking over here. All right, Delia? So you may actually get income on it, tax it. But if you're not actually getting income on it, we will check or we can tax its income generating capacity even if you have not actually earned or received the income. What did I say? If you actually receive it, it will fall under bachcho, actually let out or let out. Okay, but if it is not actually let out, the house property, what can be tax of house property? It's income generating capacity. Are you understanding or no, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay, finally, everybody, we tax, yes, income generating capacity. Now, why? That doubt may also come. See, because I told you, first of all, you will understand that also. I think I'm getting better at my drawing. No problem. Wow, wow, wow. Better. Okay? So, roti, kapda, makan, food, clothing, shelter. Basic necessity. Correct? All of you? Basic necessity, no. But whether all of them can afford the property, ownership of the property, can everyone afford that? Tell me.
No.
Nobody, not all, everybody can afford having ownership, so they want it on rent. But again, that 80-20 ratio or that Pareto analysis, you always know. Minority of people have majority of the wealth, hai na? And majority of the people have very, very low income or wealth. Clear, Delia? That is always everywhere there. Yes or no, everybody? So, assume Guru has 5 properties. Okay, Guru got a lottery. He has some business. He is not telling us which business. But Guru has 5 properties. Five houses. Okay, 5 houses. Correct? And how much houses Guru actually requires to stay or live? Tell me this.
One.
Only one.
One.
Sufficient, na, Guru? One house is okay, no? Okay. Only one property is sufficient for Guru. And AD? Okay, fine. Okay. And then he has now extra property. How much?
4.
Now he has what extra properties are? 4. Okay, everybody. Now, he is not using those 4 properties, let us say. And neither giving that property on rent. He has lots of demand or lots of requests from people. Please give it on rent. I will pay you rent. We are looking for rent. Guru is like, no, I don't want anybody to touch my property. I don't want anybody to step on my property. Don't come in my property. I'll keep it vacant, but I will not give it on rent. Okay? Finally. So what does income tax law say? Okay, no problem. Don't actually give it on the rent, but we will still tax you. We will still tax you based on its income generating capacity. Okay. Now here what happens? First of all, there are 2 benefits. Hai na? 2 benefits. First of all, income tax will get its revenue. Hai na? Tax they will get. Because they are taxing income generating capacity. Okay, everybody? Fine. And secondly, it will also encourage people who have extra properties to actually give it on the rent. Na? You tell me, do we have a situation in India where real estate is, everybody has a home or the rent is so subsidized in India? Subsidized means you check. If you check actually economy, rent is very high comparatively. Okay, in India also. Fine, Delia? Because supply is limited and demand is, you know, demand and number of people, though you know obviously what is happening here. All of you okay, Delia, or no? Tell me.
Yes.
Everybody. Yes, sir.
So here, income tax department will get its revenue. by taxing it generates its income generating capacity. As well as now those who are the owners of the property, if they are not giving it on rent, but still getting taxed or no, tell me. Yes or no? So income tax department wants encouraging people to give it on rent. So owner will also get some actual rent, but importantly, bachcho, there will be some person, tenant, who will get a property to stay in. Understood or no, everybody? Government is not saying that they give the property on free of cost. No, charge if you have to, but give it. Don't keep the property vacant or unutilized. Clear or not, all of you? If there is a property, then either give it for rent or we are going to tax you. Understood, all of you?
Yes.
If you actually give it on rent, as it is, we are still taxing you. Hai na? If you actually give it on rent, we are still taxing you only. But we don't want any idle, you understand? Just sitting, okay, a useless property. Clear? That's why this concept is important that we tax on its income generation capacity. Clear, tell you all of you? So many people, you understand now, would have invested so much just as an investment property. You might have heard that. Weekend homes, investment property only. Hai na? And they are not giving it to anybody. So those properties which you what get, they get taxed. Clear all of you? Yeah. Because of COVID actually, little bit has again, it has become relaxed in case of real estate. Rents have come down. Properties are vacant. This is happening. Okay, everybody. Anyways, now understand. So assumed to be let out. Where as soon as I say assumed, keep one thing in mind. Is there an actual cash inflow? Tell me. Answer is no, because we are assuming it to be what? Deemed to be let out. Okay. Assuming it to be let out. Assumed, na? So did we actually let out? No. So since we have not actually let out, are we getting any income? No. So there is no cash inflow. Did you understand, everybody? All of you? Are you high now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So pay attention. If the assessee owns more than two house properties, okay, owns more than two house properties, okay, then only two would be treated as SOP and others would be treated as deemed to be let out. Okay, understand an example now. Okay, I'll just give you an example. House one, I'll just give you various examples now. You try to tell me, okay, quickly. There is one house. SOP, you understand now? Self-occupied property. Everyone okay till here?
Yes, sir.
So what will be the status? This is actuals. What will be the status for income tax purpose also? SOP only. There is one property. You're self-occupying, income tax says, no problem, it is SOP. Clear or not, everybody? Everyone okay till here? Another example, there is one property, it is actually let out. There is only one property, okay? Another person, okay? He has only one property and he's given it on rent. So actually it is let out. So what for income tax purpose also, what it is considered as? Let out. Will be considered as SOP? No. Will be considered as deemed to be let out? No. Because it is actually let out. Yes or no, all of you? Another example. House 1. House 2. Pay attention, everybody. All of you okay till here? House 1. House 2. Actuals. What is happening? Pay attention. House number 1 is used for self-occupied. And this is again a very common example. And there is one extra property. That person has actually given it on rent. Clear till here? What will be the status for income tax purpose of H1 and H2? But you tell me. Same or not? Same or different? Tell me.
Different.
Like what? House will be considered as what now?
SOP.
SOP. And house 2?
Let out.
तो सेम ही हुआ ना फिर
हाँ
the actuals and that for the tax purpose I am saying Is it okay, everybody? No issues till here? Fine?
Yes, sir.
Hayana. Fine. House one, house two, okay? Fine. Actually, pay attention now. Everyone pay attention. This is also SOP, self-occupied. And house number two is also not given on rent. So I'll take it here also, what, bachcho? SOP. So someday he stays there, someday he stays there. Some days in house one and some days in house two. Or some months in house one, some number of months in house two. Okay? Finally, all of you. For income tax purpose, now tell me, bachcho. House one will be considered as what? SOP or deemed to be let out?
SOP.
House two also SOP. Yes, everybody? House two also SOP. Clear or not, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Because up to two properties are allowed to be considered as SOP, self-occupied. It is again considered as. Now understand, the actual story starts from here. So whenever you have now, you have to check more than two properties. You have to be careful. Understand now, please pay attention. Let us say I'll give you some city. House one is in Chennai. House two is in Bangalore. Okay, and house three is in, let us say, Pune. Okay, tell you. Fine or no, everybody? Oh, Assessi has three house properties in different cities. Clear, all of you? Actually, what is happening? Pay attention. Actuals. Some days or some months he stays in Chennai. So it is SOP. Some days or some months he stays in Bangalore. But importantly, it is not given on rent. Okay, it is not given on rent. So this is also SOP. But Pune property has let out. Any problem here? For a tax purpose, bachcho, tell me whether whatever is actually, again, same thing will also happen in tax purpose also. House one SOP, house two also SOP, and house three is actually let out, so let out, no issues here. Yes or no, all of you? Fine. Everyone tell me. Any doubt till here?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
But now check, I am changing the example. House 3, he did not get any tenant and that property is vacant. It is vacant. So vacant hai. So it is also, is it, now pay attention, is it actually let out? No. Okay, finally, I am talking of actual practical life. He has 3 homes. Understand, as soon as you say there is no tenant at all, there is no rent agreement. Are you understanding? There is no tenant or there is no agreement. There is no cash inflow. It cannot be considered as let out. So if I say in the reverse way, only when you will consider a property is let out, only and only and only when there is a tenant. Actually tenant involved, giving you some money for occupation, use of the property. Understood or no? So in the textbook also, bachcho, you can write down one thing. It is not possible for him to travel in three cities. It can be self-occupied or there is another word also, unoccupied. That means unoccupied by the assessee. Okay, all of you? Unoccupied by the assessee. Fine, all of you? Likha? Written? Tell me. Basically, all the three properties he has, he may visit Pune or not visit Pune. Okay, that is completely up to his choice. But there is no tenant in Pune property. Tell me, guys. For tax purpose, what will happen? Aditya?
More than two not allowed.
More than two not allowed as SOP, no?
Yes, sir.
Only two allowed as SOP, everybody? Guru?
Yes, sir.
Only two properties allowed as SOP or not? Check. Yes. If the assessee owns more than two house properties, then only two properties will be considered as SOP and the other will be treated as deemed to be
let out.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
I hope you understood the difference between this example. And the next one which we did. What is the main difference between both the examples?
So one is actually letter, another
very good,
one is
very being. Good, very good. In the above example, one is actually, one of the properties actually let out. So there is no doubt about it. You cannot assume other things. Okay, everybody? Pakka? But in here, yes, second example, all three properties are either unoccupied or self-occupied. That is unoccupied also. So he has option to choose only two of them as SOP. Clear or not? And the other one will be which what? Some of the, one property in this will be what? Deemed to be let out. Now, when I take it as SOP, it means what? Is there a tax on it? If I consider any property as SOP, is there a tax on it?
No.
No, because GAV is?
Nil.
Nil. Very good. Latek, Guru, understood or no?
Yes, sir. Hmm. Yes, sir.
Guru, doubt push on. Don't carry forward the doubts later on. Hmm. Everyone pay attention now. So, if the property is SOP, self-occupied, the gross annual value is nil, no income. But if the property is deemed to be let out, understand now, very important. If the property is deemed to be let out, then check. Deemed means you have to assume one of the properties, okay? Or depending how many properties you have. GAB would be step one. Step one. What is step one?
Expected rent.
Very good. Expected rent. Hire of MV or FR subject to SR. Why will we not compare it with step number two? Use common sense now.
There is no actual rent.
There is no actual rent. Very smart. Jagas, badia. Simple or not? Understood everybody? I hope you have written over there. In expected rent, you can write down there. Okay, that is step one is what? Expected rent. Guru samja? Aditya? Okay.
Sir,
बोलो
अगर उसी का घर उसका पत्नी के नाम पे है तो
पत्नी के नाम पे है देन वो डीम्ड प्रॉपर्टी हम इसको जाएंगे डीम्ड ओनरशिप विल चेक देन असेसी इटसेल्फ इज डिफरेंट सो असेसी इज डिफरेंट एंड एंटायर स्टोरी इज डिफरेंट ओके इफ इट इज कंप्लीटली इन द नेम ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी कंप्लीटली इन द नेम ऑफ स्पाउस 100% ओके एंड ऑल्सो पेड बाय स्पाउस यू अंडरस्टैंड ना देन इट विल बी स्पाउसेस प्रॉपर्टी ओनली. So that will be checked in her hands. In her hands or whoever is the spouse. That will be a separate income tax file or in separate income tax calculation for that assessee. Assessee itself gets what? Diverted or you can say bifurcated. But for deemed ownership, that concept will do later on when you have joint ownership, okay? Between husband and wife, okay? Joint ownership also we are going to do. That will do in this chapter only. But if the property is only on the name of spouse, but the loan is taken, spouse minus is, let us say wife. The property is only in the name of wife. But the loan is taken and repaid by the husband. Then it is again split between both of them. Okay? So those complications we'll see. Don't worry. Any doubt till now for this? Ask me variety of variation. Ask me variation. No problem. Is it okay till here? Tell me. Now pay attention. Now we have option or not. Please, now let me check how much you actually understood. Three properties, all three are either unoccupied. Tenant is not there. Now we have an option to choose two of the properties as SOP. That means by default, in this example, one of them will be deemed to be let out. And deemed to be let out, step number one is what, bachcho? I mean, your GAV is what? Expected rent. You use logic and tell me which property will you take as deemed to be let out from the client's point of view or assessee's point of view. As a tax consultant point of view, which property will you consider as deemed to be let out of the three properties?
Less income generating capacity.
Fantastic. Out of the three properties, now you have the option. Hai ki nahi, all of you. Okay. You have the option to choose. No, that which two properties I'll take as SOP. Okay. That means the third property will be taken as deemed to be let out. So I will take that property as deemed to be let out because that will get taxable. I'll take that property as deemed to be let out. Whose? Expected rent is the least. Yes or no? Everybody? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting my point, everybody?
Yes.
Pay attention, everyone. Let us say majority of the time he stays in Chennai only. Bangalore, Pune property are unoccupied, vacant. Okay? I'm writing here ER. expected rent which you have done in step one. I'm just giving you example, okay? 20,000 per month, okay? 15,000 per month. Pay attention, I'm giving you a little bit complicated example. He stays all days in Chennai only, okay? Throughout the year. Bangalore, Pune properties is vacant. They are just investment properties and he's also not giving it on rent. Chennai expected rent is 20,000 per month. Bangalore property is 15,000 per month. And Pune property is invested very outskirts, the outskirts of the city, which has expected rent of 10,000 rupees per month. I'm purposely telling you that he always stays in Chennai. Bangalore, Pune property are vacant. What do you think? Which property you'll take as deemed to be let out?
Pune.
Chennai, Bangalore or Pune?
Pune.
Pune. Or Chennai? See, deemed to be let out, bachcho will be taxable. Deemed to be let out, bachcho will be taxable. Yes or no, all of you? Everyone okay or
yes,
not?
Sir.
So, we'll take that property as deemed to be let out, whose expected rent is the least. In that case, bachcho what? Pune. He may be actually using the property or not. Is he actually given on rent? No. Is he actually also, doesn't matter, is it actually given? No. He has more than two properties? Yes. So only two of them will be SOP, the other will be considered as what deemed to be let out. Clear dealer, all of you? Yes?
Yes, sir.
If I add one more property in this, now pay attention. Any other good city in South? Pondi? Which city should I take?
Sir.
Bolo.
Sir, agar property outside India hui to.
Ek minute. Then what will you check? Tell me. Hey Guru, what is the city name?
Yes, sir. Mera city na.
Hampi.
Hampi. Bidar.
Hampi.
Hubli. Kya?
Hampi. Hampi.
Hampi. Hampi mein do?
Nahi sir. Bidar.
Ah, Bidar.
Uskar bol raha hai sir.
House 4, I'm just giving you example, okay? Expected rent also depends on fair rent, na? In Bidar, he has a building. Five floor building in Bidar. Okay? Expected rent is 30,000 rupees per month. This is also SOP, means it is unoccupied or SOP, but actually not let out. Okay, everybody. Staying always in Chennai. Still tell me now, bachcho, which property you'll take it as what? Deemed to be let out.
Second.
Now you have to choose. Now there are four properties. Only two are allowed as SOP. So other will be bachcho deemed to be let out. I'll choose from the two lowest.
Yes, sir.
In this example now.
2 and 3.
Very good. Wow, wow, wow.
Sir, income tax wale nahi dekhte ke, sir, kahan pe reh rahe ho, sab wo nahi poochte.
You have to file income tax return for that, no? They check PIN code also. You have to enter PIN code, etc. in the income tax return of your properties. So they understand. Now, each and every case, they cannot check. But when they check, then they'll check everything, no?
Yes, sir.
That's why you also call it a self-assessment. Self. There is a concept of self-assessment, you will understand. When you are filing income tax return, the officer is not coming at your home, or you are not going to office to fill the return. Ah, this is correct or not. It is filled, let us say, by the assessee, or it is assessee's duty to fill the return, and which is correct or accurate. When the officer picks up your case randomly, there are other provisions for that. Then he will check everything. The valuation is matching or not, everything is correct or not, you know? Clear? So, bachcho,
sir,
in this example, house property number 2 and 3, I take it as deemed to be let out. Clear? And I'll consider obviously house 1 and 4 in this example as SOP. Clear?
Sir, they give us option to choose property to
it is our option.
Out.
Yes.
Option.
Yes, it is our option. See, as long as there is no tenant in the property, okay, it is either SOP or now in case of that deemed to be let out. So it is your choice. Okay. Now, even if, now let me say, he shifted his base, I'll keep the same example, but he shifted his own base, the SSE, from Chennai to Bangalore. He got a job in, he's working now in Bangalore. He has four properties. All four properties are not yet let out. He shifted his base in Bangalore. Okay? Clear or not, bacho? Still in this case, we will still take this combination only. That house 2 and 3 are considered as deemed to be let out. Is it actually let out? No. It is in fact, actually practically speaking, it may be SOP. But still for tax purpose, bacho, it will be considered as deemed to be let out. Clear till here, everybody?
Abhi in house 4 ka sir income generating capacity 40,000 hai sir.
I'll change a what? Okay.
In house 4 ka sir.
Chalo, theek hai, 40.
और अब अगर हमने किसी को रेंट पे दिया तो वो 30,000 था सर.
अच्छा, ओके.
इनकम जनरेटिंग कैपेसिटी बोले तो सर स्टैंडर्ड रेंट हुआ ना सर.
हाँ
हाँ सर, तो दोनों में कौन सा ये होता है सर, दोनों का टैक्स सेम ही रहता है ना सर.
इनकम जनरेटिंग कैपेसिटी मींस व्हाट? व्हाटएवर रेंट इनकम ओ इट कैन अर्न, ठीक है, स्टैंडर्ड रेंट, ओके फाइन. सो what I was telling you, either you'll actually earn rent, suno meri baat. If you actually earn rent, okay, then you have that again same thing to follow, but which you are doing. Step 1, what? Expected rent. Step 2, what? Actual rent. Then any of the higher of them is what? GAV. Correct? When you're actually earning rent or giving it on rent or no. Correct or wrong? But if you are not earning rent, means what? Not earning rent. It is not let out. Hai na? Not let out. So we have to check here what? It's income generating capacity. That is expected rent, but they are saying only what? Expected rent na? Higher of MV or FR subject to SR. Get out tha fir. Understood or not?
Haan sir, sir.
Pakka?
सर अभी हमने रेंट पे नहीं दिया सर, फिर भी हम इनकम टैक्स वालों को बोले हम वो रेंट पे ऐसा कर सकते हैं ना.
Why will you do that?
उस पे अगर कम रेंट मिला, कम टैक्स लगाए तो सर.
एग्जांपल दो ना उसको प्रॉपरली. यू गेटिंग रेंट और नॉट रेंट, टेल मी प्रैक्टिकली.
नॉट गेटिंग रेंट सर.
अच्छा, नॉट गेटिंग रेंट, ठीक है, ओके. अच्छा, देन यू आर सेइंग व्हाट इफ आई शो दिस एज लेस.
हां सर.
See, bhai, whatever you do in income tax return, that is your headache. Okay? It is like whenever you are giving any kind of declaration, you say all the details given are true and fair, true and correct from my belief and all of that. You may not even show an income. You may not even show is that there is a house property. You may not even show that you exist. Completely okay. But that, all of that is what? Illegal. Again, if they come to know that you exist, if they come to know that you have a house property, if they come to know you have shown less, then what will happen? What do you think? You can show less, no problem. Okay? What will happen?
Undisclosed income.
Correct. So practically what happens in income tax return, and legally speaking, there may be obviously a difference, but to some extent. If this is, it has capacity 40,000, you will show 4,000 only, then definitely you will get invitation. Chalo, come to the income tax department, let us have some tea. Let us have some discussion over tea, chai pe charcha. So that is going to happen. I hope that all of you got the idea. What is this? SOP, let out,
sir.
And deemed to be let out. Bolo.
Sir, the house 4 apan let out lag dila, tar apan house 3 and house 2 doni pan nahi na deemed let out karu shakat.
Nahi. Correct. Now, okay. What she says, pay attention. H1, H2, H3 and H4. Okay? Now what she is saying is H4 is actually let out. Barabar na? H1, H2, H3 is SOP or let us say unoccupied. This is actuals. Actuals, you understand? And for tax purpose, bachu, where we cannot make any changes?
Let out.
Very good. This will be considered as let out only. No problem about that. But here in H1 and H2 and H3, two of them will be SOP and one of them will be deemed to be let out. Okay, two SOP and one deemed to be let out. obviously I will take that as deemed to be let out, which has the lowest expected rent. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt now?
No.
Chalega? Fine. But this is like, as in, here they are allowing now two properties as SOP. So person can have two properties. If he has only two properties and both of them are not given on the rent, then no problem at all. Tell me, you know. But here then that is the reason department is saying if you have more than two properties and you're also not giving it on the rent, we are now going to tax whatever you have more than, whichever is now more than two property. Okay, bachcho? Clear to all of you? Fine. And yes, you have the option every year to choose which property will be deemed to be let out. Okay. And which two properties you're taking as SOP. Done, everybody.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll go ahead. Chalega, na? Now, again, very interesting concept. Because depending on the property, type of property, check what happens. Ceiling limit for interest. Which interest we are discussing, bachcho? 24B. Okay? Yeah. Okay, no? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by ceiling limit, bachcho?
Sir, maximum limit.
Yes, upper limit, everybody. Upper limit. Okay, everybody? Yeah. Fine. Upper limit for interest. Okay, for interest. 24B. Try to understand. 24B, interest on borrowed capital. It is a deduction or an addition?
Is it a deduction or an addition, bachcho? Deduction.
It is deduction. So, is it a good thing or a bad thing for department, income tax department?
Bad thing.
So, bad thing for income tax department. So, they will limit it. That how much benefit you can claim. Okay, everybody. One example we have already seen. They are allowing also, but over a period of time. Which one? Interest on pre-custody period. We have already seen that. Hai ki nahi? Yes, all of you. Hai na? But they are allowing over a period of 5 years. Now, your check. Depending on the type of property, there also they are saying 24B, there will be some limitations. Okay, everybody? Yes? Chalo, I am giving you time. Read this entire page. Read. Pen drive students can also pause the video and read it.
Recording stopped. हो गया तो बताओ मुझको.
ओके सृष्टि फाइन तुम लोग घर पे होगा सृष्टि वेदिका क्लास में कोई नहीं फाइन फाइन हो गया बाकी लोगों का लेट मी नो अभी कितना
हो गया सर
हो गया ना चलो
रिकॉर्डिंग इन प्रोग्रेस
सो 24B देयर आर सम लिमिट्स गिवन बाय इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट ओके और इनकम टैक्स दिस लॉ एक्ट दैट ओवर एंड अबव दैट नाउ यू मे बी एक्चुअली स्पेंडिंग ऑन दिस इंटरेस्ट बट ओवर एंड अबव सर्टेन अमाउंट इट विल नॉट बी अलाउड एज व्हाट बच्चों डिडक्शन सो कैन आई से दीज लिमिट्स आई एम जस्ट अगेन गिविंग यू एग्जांपल इफ you know upper limit is given to you you know there is an upper limit and you are spending more than that if you are spending or accruing more than that but there is an upper limit you know so whatever is more than that it will all lapse you understand lapse 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 means waste basically if the bachcho for example the ceiling limit is rupees 2 lakhs okay I'm just giving an example if the ceiling limit is rupees 2 lakhs and your interest is 2.5 lakhs can you claim 2.5 lakhs Everybody?
No.
You cannot claim 2.5 lakhs. No, if the ceiling limit is 2 lakhs and your actual interest accrued is 2.5 lakhs, can you claim 2.5? No. You can claim 2 lakhs only. That means that extra 50,000 is going waste, na? Everybody, okay? Fine, Taylor, all of you? Okay. Self-occupied property, limit applies for current as well as pre-concession interest. Okay, everybody? I'll go ahead. Did you read till the last of the page? So check the best thing is what over here. The ceiling limits which are given above do not apply at all to which properties? To a let out property as well as deemed to be let out properties. Everybody, all of you, are you getting the point or no? Please respond quickly.
Yes, sir.
So for
yes, sir.
As
yes,
well
sir.
As deemed to be let out, there is no upper ceiling limit for what? Interest on borrowed capital deduction. Because it's as it is, entire income gets taxed. Municipal tax is also you're allowing. So 24A, 24B, this will be regular. There is no limit at all. Clear, everybody? So if you're lucky, if the property is let out or deemed to be let out, 24B is without any upper limit. Clear, clear, everybody? Yeah, the problem arises in case of SOP properties, SOP. Why? Because the first thing over here is to understand the government doesn't get any income from SOP. Tell me. The government doesn't get any income from SOP, self-occupied properties, yes or no?
Yes.
That's why the deductions have a limit. Okay, so check what are they saying. And this limit includes what applies for current as well as pre-concession interest. Okay. So inclusive of both current as well as pre-concession. Okay, everybody, let's go ahead. Check. What does it say? What are the conditions? Properties acquired or constructed with capital borrowed on or after 1/4/1999. Now, like I said, whenever many changes you have on a particular date, it is from that PY or financial year, from that budget date. Okay, so from on or after 1/4/1999, if you have borrowed the capital, hai na? And then your property was acquired or constructed. Theek hai? Acquired means purchase, hai na? No problem. So check. Acquisition or construction is completed within 5 years from the end of the financial year in which the capital was borrowed. Alright, everybody till here. In which the capital was borrowed. From that year's end, within 5 years, construction is completed or acquisition is completed. So basically these are all your conditions. Thirdly, such interest is payable in respect of amount advanced for acquisition or construction of the house or as a refinance of the principal amount outstanding under earlier loan taken for acquisition or construction. Basically, bachcho, just one thing important is here. What should be the purpose of the loan? Tell me this. Only two
acquisition purpose. Or construction.
Only two purpose now, bachcho, here. Acquisition or construction, but can you see that here also? बट हैव वी सीन 24B इन जनरल इज अलाउड फॉर टोटल फाइव रीजंस, रिपेयर्स, रिन्यूअल, रिकंस्ट्रक्शन एंड देन एक्विजिशन एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन. दैट्स व्हाई दोज थ्री अदर्स आर पुट इन अदर क्राइटेरिया. ओके, रिपेयर्स, रिन्यूअल एंड रिकंस्ट्रक्शन आर पुट इन अदर क्राइटेरिया. अंडरस्टूड और नो बच्चों, एवरीबॉडी? सो द प्रॉपर्टी इज फॉर एक्विजिशन और रिकंस्ट्रक्शन और फॉर सॉरी कंस्ट्रक्शन. ओके, एंड दिस कंडीशन आर फॉलोड. देन चेक वॉट इज द सीलिंग लिमिट. Actual rebate interest payable subject to maximum of rupees 2 lakhs aggregate. Clear till here all of you? Total how much bachcho? 2 lakhs. Do you remember rebate 87A? Is there a ceiling limit on the rebate?
12,500.
There is a ceiling limit, no? So your actual liability may be less than 12,500 or more than 12,500. Hai na bachcho? If it is less than 12,500, we were giving entire amount of rebate or what? No, na? If my tax liability was 5,000, how much rebate I was giving? 5,000. But if my tax liability was 15,000, how much rebate I can give? 12,500. Similarly here, my if my interest accrued is 1.5 lakhs, how much can I claim? 1.5 lakhs. Understood or no, bachcho? But if my interest accruing is 2.5 lakhs, how much I'll claim? 2 lakhs. That is the reason, obviously, that is ceiling limit or up to that amount we can claim. All of you okay till here? Yeah? So check. Second category. Properties repair is for the purpose of, the loan is taken for the purpose of bachcho, repair, renewal or reconstruction. Then without any date etc. you can check, you don't have to check date etc. What is the limit? 30,000. Okay all of you? Aggregate, hai na? For SOP. And second criteria, before 1/4/1999, before 1/4/1999, then again aggregate limit is what bachcho? 30,000. Okay or not all of you? 30,000. But anything said and done, the assessee may have one property, two property, three properties, five properties, whatever. He is going to consider only maximum two properties as SOP. This much you understand now? He is going to consider maximum only two properties as SOP. Yes or no? So yes. For these two properties, cumulative maximum he can claim deduction is of rupees 2 lakhs. Okay everybody? So total cap limit. Cap means cap. It is capped. Upper limit. For all of the above cases. For all of the above cases. For SOP properties. Is what bachcho? 2 lakhs. Understood or no? So there may be 2-3 loans. One for acquisition. One for renewal. One before 99. Whatever. But whatever said and done, for whatever SOPs you have, n number of SOP, 1 or 2 SOPs, total maximum you can get deduction now is what, bachcho? How much? Limited to 2 lakh rupees. Okay, everybody? Yes? And let out and deemed to be let out, bachcho, tell me, what is the limit? There is no limit. So check the diagram. You'll get a diagram over here. Can you see the diagram also in the textbook? Read it again and check whether it is your understanding correctly or not. Read it.
Recording stopped.
Go from the left hand side if you want. That is smaller. Deductions allowed from NAV 24A and 24B. If the property is let out, let me just quickly say.
Recording in progress.
If the property is let out or deemed to be let out, 24A and 24B, no problem. 24A allowed because NAV will be positive. And 24B, bachcho, fully allowed. No conditions over there. No issues. Understood, everybody? No problem till here. Tell me. But if the property is SOP, self-occupied property or properties, hai na, everybody? Then 24A is nil. I hope you know that 24A, standard deduction will be nil because NAV is nil. For SOP, है ना? उसके आगे, after that check, interest and borrowed capital now check, it depends on the purpose taken or not, check. If it is for repair, renewal, reconstruction, maximum how much? 30,000, can you see that? So to check the bachcho purpose, repair, renewal, reconstruction, those three, you can say reasons, 30,000. Without, you will not even check the date when you have taken the loan, 30,000 direct. Then, but if it's for acquisition or construction, then here again you will check the date. अगेन यू विल चेक द डेट. इफ द लोन वॉज टेकन बिफोर 1499 देन अगेन 30,000. बट द लोन इज टेकन बच्चों आफ्टर 1499, ऑब्वियसली टाइम वैल्यू ऑफ मनी है ना बच्चों, इन्फ्लेशन एक्सेट्रा है ना. देन द लिमिट वॉज इंक्रीज टू वॉट बच्चों 2 lakhs है कि नहीं, दैट ऑल्सो इन टोटलिटी ओके एवरीथिंग. बट अगेन यूर सर सर्टन कंडीशन, लोन वॉज टेकन ऑन और आफ्टर 1499 फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन और एक्विजिशन. And the acquisition or construction was completed within how many years, bachcho? Tell me. It is completed within how many years? It is completed within 5 years from the end of the financial year in which the capital was borrowed. Correct? And plus certificate from lender. Lender means bank, specifying interest payable. So bank will basically give a certificate. This is the interest for the year. Based on that, we can properly claim it in our income tax return. Okay, all of you? Fine till here? Tell me. So, if the condition is not satisfied, bachcho, then again how much we'll give? But 30,000. But all the conditions satisfied, then we'll give bachcho maximum how much? 20,000. Clear or not? Everyone tell me. Okay? But everything said and done. Is there a limit for this? Any situations? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
This is very important. Maximum how much bachcho rupees?
2 lakh.
Yes, never forget that. They will give you different types of loan, different type of purpose. You just take all the SOP together and say maximum it can be 2 lakhs. Okay, all of you, okay? Understood?
Sir, म्हणजे त्याने पहिले एक एसओपी असली त्याची आणि तिथे जर त्याचं ते लिमिट संपलं असेल 2 लाखचं तर मग नेक्स्ट
No use of another house property loan. No use there of another house property. If one property you already have and already the limit is exhausted there, then even if you take new property, in totality still, maximum is only 2 lakhs, then there is no benefit.
ओके आणि जर म्हणजे ते मागाशी आपण हाऊस 1, 2, 3, 4 घेतलं होतं तसं जर त्यांनी ते इंटरेस्ट रिकवर होईपर्यंत जर ती प्रॉपर्टी लेट आउट म्हणून दाखवली तर
तो चलेगा ना. येस येस येस. If he's paying this interest on the loan and he is actually occupying it, okay, then he can consider it as deemed to be let out. Actually means when I say more than two property, yeah? More than two property.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine, everybody. Let me just give you an example. Don't write down. If there is only one house, he is actually occupying it. Okay, everybody? He is what, bachcho? Actually occupying it. Okay? And there is only one property. And if he pays rupees 5 lakhs as interest, how much deduction can he claim?
2 lakhs.
Can he show this house one as now let out? Deemed to be let out?
No.
That deemed to be let out option will start only after second property. Okay? Fine. Another way to look at this, pay attention if you understood good. If there is only one house, he is actually occupying it. Right? In that case, his limit is what, bachcho? 2 lakhs. Clear? Achha, let me ask you, then what is the situation in which case you can think he can claim this? He can claim entire rupees 5 lakhs as deduction. There is only one house. Then what will you have to do to claim entire rupees 5 lakhs as deduction? What will you have to do? What do you think?
Let out minus dakhavi lagel.
Dakhavi lagel. Dikhana padega. You have to show it.
Or actually, you have to let out.
My question is SOP or let out or deemed to be let out?
Let out.
You cannot have deemed to be let out without having more than
two property.
So here the situation can be that he goes away from this home, goes away from this house, he actually lets it out, he gives it on rent, and he himself stays somewhere else on rent. That is different. Hekini. Then he can claim entire rupees 5 lakhs as deduction. Clear all everybody? Are you getting the point or no? All of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now pay attention. If there is only one house, and is actually let out. When I say let out, means actually let out. What is your deduction ceiling limit? Or What is the amount we'll get as deduction?
5 lakh.
5 lakh rupees, bachcho. Very good. Understood, everybody?